Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture we'll be studying the concept of spectrum sensing. Spectrum sensing basically means we have to sense or identify the free frequency bands in which the user will be able to transmit. So once we are able to identify what are the frequencies that are free to transmit, it should be used or it can be given to other users. So the key requirement of the cognitive radio is to identify what amount of the spectrum is free, that is, or what amount of the spectrum is used by the other users. Spectrum sensing basically means that to identify what part of the time and the frequency axis is not being used by the users. Here we can see that on the x-axis we have time, on the y-axis we have power, and on the z-axis we have frequency. We can see here that some part of the frequency is being utilized, whereas some bands of the frequency are kept empty. So once we are able to identify what are the spectrum or the bands of the frequency kept empty, we are able to allocate those frequency bands to other users. Here we can see that there are broad frequency bands being allocated. In between the medium or the smaller frequency band that you see is nothing but the guard channels that are being used to separate the frequencies. Now we'll move to the concept of spectrum sensing in the hierarchical system. Spectrum sensing in hierarchical system means that we have primary users and we have secondary users, or we have primary devices and secondary devices. So for the secondary devices, it is important to sense the spectrum that is freely available. But the problem here is, while able to sense, we are only able to sense the transmitted signal. As the antenna is transmitting, the secondary devices are able to identify what is the frequency being transmitted. The problem here is to identify the frequency that has been received. As the receiver is receiving multiple frequencies, or the area or the environment near the antenna has multiple frequencies, it is difficult to identify which is the exact frequency the receiver is going to receive. So the main key problem here is to identify the received frequency. So a completely passive receiver is invisible to the sensor. So there are some solutions being provided in order to identify the receiver frequency. Let us see what are these solutions. The first solution is that the secondary devices should be able to understand the duplexing technique that is being used. So once we are able to understand this duplexing technique, and if I know the frequency on which the transmitting signal is transmitting, then I can easily manage and easily understand or recognize the frequency on which the receiver is going to receive the signal. So frequency duplexing is one of the techniques. The second technique is to observe the spurious emissions from the receiver. Ideally, the receiver should not emit any energy. But practically, the antenna is not isolated to the receiver. Hence, certain energy that has been received by the receiver antenna gets re-emitted back. Hence, once the secondary system is able to identify these emissions, it is easy to find out what is the frequency on which the receiver is receiving. So, transmitted frequency anyways we can identify. Here, we are also able to identify the received frequency. Thus, spectrum sensing becomes easier. But this approach of identifying the spurious emissions from the receiver has a drawback. The drawback is that since the receiver is emitting, it is not an ideal receiver. It will lead to losses in the signal. It will also punish the good design of the receiver. The next solution to sense the spectrum or the frequency of the receiver is to assume that the receivers are available in all those areas where the primary transmitters are available, in which the primary device is already transmitting, and if the secondary device is also transmitting, remember in CDMA the frequencies are same. Hence the transmit power of the primary will increase in order to maintain the signal to interference ratio or the signal to noise ratio. And thus we are able to identify the frequency bands in which the signal or the primary device is transmitting. But this solution has certain drawbacks. The first drawback is that we are directly interfering the primary devices. The second drawback is that we are not able to change, or we are not able to separate the interference among the primary and the secondary devices, since the information has also been transmitted by the secondary device. And finally, this system does not work with those transmitters that are not changing depending on the characteristics of the channel. That is, if there is interference, then the transmission should change. in such a way that we have to either increase the signal to noise ratio or we have to maintain other modulation formats. So if the transmission is not changing depending on the other interferences, then this system is not of use. The next solution is to use a common control channel, which will give the information of the spectrum that is being used. For example, it will tell us that where is the received frequency that is being used. This gives a very high spectrum efficient utilization. And the last solution is to have a database which will provide the geographical locations of all the receivers that are available. That is the primary receivers. And thus we can identify or spectrum sensing will be possible. So to identify the or sense the spectrum, there are other methods been available, that is using of detectors. Detectors help identify the frequency bands. There are three types of detectors which are basically being used. The first is the energy detector. Then we have matched filters. And finally, we have cyclostationarities. Let us see what is the meaning of this one by one. So the first one is the energy detection. Energy detection is used when the sensor has got no information about the structure of the waveform. Since the sensor has got no information about the structure or the kind of waveform being transmitted, then it is easy to identify the energy that is being transmitted. If there is no signal present, then the sensor is going to only measure the noise. That is the thermal noise. And if the signal is present, then the sensor is going to measure signal as well as the thermal noise which is present. Match filters provide better results, but it is only possible when the transmitted signal is known. That is, once we know what is the kind of signal that has been transmitted, then by using the match filter, we are able to sense what is the signal being transmitted by the next waveform. For a spectrum sensing cognitive radio, the output of this match filter is used as a test element to identify that whether the energy of the signal is present in the considered band or not. The next way to identify using a detector is using the cyclostationarities. Cyclostationarities are using the fact that the information about the waveform is not required over here. Cyclostationarity means that certain amount of information is getting periodically repeated in the waveform itself. So once we are able to identify the periodic nature of the waveform, it is easy for us to detect it. This fact can be used to enhance the performance of the energy detectors. Another way through which we can detect is using the cognitive pilot channels. These pilot channels gives us the information about what amount of spectrum is going to be free. There are different methods or ways in which we can use this cognitive radio channels. So the procedure for using the CPC or the cognitive pilot channels is in three following ways. The first way is that the cognitive radio channel is listened or it is heard at the start of the transmission itself. The second way is that the network or the terminal gets the information during the transmission and then it selects the most suitable format. And finally, the CPC or the cognitive pilot channel is being broadcast to wide area or personal area networks. In this way, we are able to find out what is the amount of the spectrum that is going to be free. Hence, spectrum sensing is possible in such a way that it is available for the other users. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.